One, two, three, four, five. Happy New Year, everybody. Welcome back to Cook It with Johnny Mac. I'm here with T-Money. Happy New Year. It's 2021. Let's hope that it's a better year for everybody. We all know what happened last year.
Coronavirus.
And, you know, I just want to introduce Rocco to the show. He hasn't had a chance to be on the show. And that's my boy. He's on the logo. And Rocco's a crazy dog, and he loves cake. So I'm barefoot behind here. No weird stuff going on. But we're going to do an amazing tuna salad today. And this is a recipe I don't break out. There's only one key ingredient that I don't tell anybody, but I'm going to tell you today, back after this.
Tell me, when will you be mine?
T-Money and I were in Bloomingdale's today, and the reason why we were there was because I love Alex, the sales rep. He's an awesome retail guy, and he actually sold me this shirt. It's great for portly guys, and it's a Ralph Lauren. And, you know, I asked him for a tuna sandwich not too long ago, and we laughed. So 40 Carats inside Bloomingdale's has a great tuna sandwich. I don't know if you ever ate there, but I like to go shopping at my favorite store, Bloomingdale's. We keep it clean here. No booze, man. I got the gout. No more tequila. I started 2021 with the gout. And I wish they would change that name because it sounds like an STD or something.
But he said shenanigans.
Hey, Alex. Good to see you, man. You'll follow me. I want to try this on. I was in here a couple weeks ago. I don't know if you remember me. Bloomingdale's my favorite. While I try this on, can you do me a favor? Can you go up to 40 carats for me? Can you get me a tuna sandwich?
Tuna?
Yeah, and bring me a bottle of Pana.
You smell like tuna. Mr. John, I have your tuna.
Thanks, Alex. Not everybody craves tuna, but when I used to be hungover, man, I liked a nice greasy mayonnaise tuna sandwich. So, you know, years ago, I don't know if you ever noticed, tuna used to be much better. You know, I know a lot of the younger folks out there don't really realize that. But when we were younger, it was more loin meat and less flake. So as these companies develop and try to scam out the public with an inferior product little by little, like toilet paper, for say.
Dwight, why is the toilet paper only half a ply?
Toilet paper used to be a lot nicer, right? Now it's narrow, you need more, right? It breaks apart. We don't want to get into that topic right now while we're making tuna, but, you know, you get the point. So I'm using Bumblebee Prime Filet Solid Albacore. And we're going to open up a can. We're going to take a look at it, and we're going to see what's in there today. And, you know, if I do eat tuna, and I do still eat it sometimes, I like this product. I also wanted to plug my favorite Duke's mayonnaise from down south. We love Duke's. We're going to use that because it's smooth and creamy, right? Been around since 1917. Come on. If you touch it, you scream. Capiche? I'm just going to do a simple tuna salad, right? And I'm featuring here Balthazar croissants, which are phenomenal. We're going to put the salad on a croissant. We're going to plate it in a little bit. And one thing I wanted to talk to you about was the Canada tuna. I mean, I don't think a lot of people at home are washing the tops. You know what I mean? That's imperative. God knows what's going on in the supermarket after we go home, right? So I always try to rub it down. And I'm sure your grandmother's not doing this. Matter of fact, I could bet on it. So all the kids that are going to grandma's house, make sure she washes the can. Okay? All right, so we're going to open this up. We're going to take a look inside. So, Tim, there you go. Look what we're eating, man, these days. I mean, this is America, man. Are you serious? Look at this. This is like glued together. Now, I'm not going to keep mentioning their names, but there's a lot of flake in here, man. I just want to see all loin meat like I did in the 70s. My mother would make me a tuna sandwich. Big hero. Did you get a look at that tuna? I mean, what the hell is going on, man? Who's taking the good meat? I mean, they're screwing us here in our country. My mother, the tuna was beautiful back in the heyday, you know. Star-kissed, all of that beautiful loin meat, chicken of the sea. This is like cat food, but I'm going to eat it today because, you know, listen, we don't know, but when we mix it, right, we mix it up with mayonnaise, nobody knows anything, right? You can hide anything, and you can hide a toenail in there. So we're going to mix this up. We're going to eat it, I guess. You know, listen, I'm not drunk. I like eating them drunk by the pool in Vegas. That's what I used to do. And let the tuna fall over my stomach. because I didn't care anymore, right? That's why I don't have a girlfriend. Okay, all right, so here we go. Now, I don't like my tuna chopped up too small. I like it a little chunky, so, because I want to see actual meat in there. I don't know what the hell the 8th Avenue Deli is putting in there, right? They use this product called Skipjack, and if you ever see that stuff, that is the worst tuna you'll ever see in your life. And I know people have eaten it because they don't know what they're buying. First question I ask is when I go in to get a tuna sandwich is, hey, man, is that solid white albacore? I mean, you could tell. But another thing they do is they put crackers in there to make it white. There's a lot of scams. So they put cracker meal in there. And a lot of times the crackers, especially the Jewish delis, they put a lot of cracker meal in there. Or they smash up crackers. And that stops the tuna from, you know, the mayonnaise from weeping, you know. It doesn't purge. So it kind of holds it together. But you're eating a bunch of crackers. I mean, the red onion's your preference. I'm not going more than that. So I used like a quarter of a red onion, right? I'm going to throw it in there. I diced it up. Trade secret, just a little pinch of salt. Put a little truffle salt in there. Nobody has to know that. That's our secret. My dog loves tuna fish. I wouldn't even give the flake to my dog. This guy's spoiled, man. He eats filet mignon. But I'm going to give him a little. All right, Rocco. Good boy. Hi, TJ. Trade secret. So just a pinch of truffle salt I put in there, a little black pepper. Now, here's the secret ingredient. This guy told me years ago when I worked in a hotel, he goes, you know how to make a good tuna sauce? He goes, just put a little Dijon mustard in there. So that's it. This is simple stuff. And the last thing I'm going to put in there, well, the second to the last thing is my fake lemon juice, because I don't give a shit, man. I like the Sicilian lemon juice. All you guys that say, hey, he's not using fresh. Go screw yourself, man. This is good stuff. This, you know why I like it for this? Because you can control it, you know? So I just put a couple of dashes in there. And that's that. So we got that. We got the mustard. We got the trade secret. And now what we're going to do is we're going to add the Dukes, baby, because I love Dukes. Now, when it comes to my tuna salad, I like the mayonnaise, but I just want enough to coat it because I think what you're doing is the lemon and the mustard kind of adds a little moisture to it. And, you know, this is the look I'm going for, you know. And I got to tell you, man, I think this is going to be nice. Even though there's a lot of flake meat in there. And Starkist screw us. Or Bumblebee. Bumblebee screwed us on one can. Okay. So I'm going to give it a little taste. I gotta tell you, not bad. Not bad. Okay, I just wanted to give you a little trade secret here. When it comes to croissants, bagels, and you plate tuna salad, you know, obviously you cut down and it squirts out all over. So what you want to do is you want to pre-cut it, okay? And just do half at a time. So this way it doesn't get all over your customer's hands or your guest's hands, right? So here we go. I'm going to take this rag out of the way. And I love tuna on croissant. I mean, it's just amazing. So, a little radish zest on this. Just add a little flavor. Okay. All right. So, there you go. And we're gonna dive in. Tim, let's eat. You ready?
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart. For it's hard, you will find, to be narrow of mind if you're young at heart. You can go to extremes with impossible schemes. You can laugh when your dreams fall apart at the seams, and life becomes exciting with each passing day, and love is easy.
Thanks for stopping in today.
buddy.